Well, good evening, everyone, and welcome to Song of the Shadows. We are so grateful that you all are here to join us, and I just have a few things I'd like to share with you. I want to start by thanking everyone who is part of the choir, part of the orchestra. If you look at your program, you'll see how many different churches are represented up here. And also down here, people who generously donate their time and their talent, a labor of love to make this beautiful program come to life, and we're so grateful for that. And of course, our fearless leader, Marshall Winnicott, who works so tirelessly to put it all together. We're very grateful to her as well. We're also very thankful to the Columbia schools. Columbia High School has graciously offered this space to us to be used today. And as we thank the school, we have to make specific thanks to Allison Grady. She and her students, they pulled in the piano and all manner of other things. The students all pitched in to help get the space set up tonight, as well as our custodial staff. I know Brandon and others have been here since very early today and yesterday and many days in between, and we're so grateful for all that. We're always grateful to Parma Symphony. This year they are they're the ones who loaned us the risers to be able to use, and we can't use regular choir risers because they're too narrow, but Parma Symphony was gracious to let us borrow theirs so that we can set up chairs up here, and also the little orchestra lights that they are always allowing us to borrow too. And then Mr. Jim Heinrich, who is our sound whiz. He's responsible for making us all sound good, making sure you all can hear us as we present this program. There's some housekeeping items. I want to remind you, if you've not already done so, please turn off your cell phone. Make sure it is silenced. This is a very powerful program, and you're going to be in a contemplative spirit as you listen, as you immerse yourself in it, and we don't want a cell phone to go off in the middle of that. That might spoil the effect, so please silence your cell phones. Restrooms are in the hallways, in the main hallways, and there's an accessible restroom just through that little door right there. It's a ladies' restroom. I'm told the men's restroom that is on this floor that is accessible is just outside this side door here. And let's see, was there anything else? At the end of the program today, I know that it is tempting whenever a beautiful piece of music finishes to applaud. But this is not that kind of thing that we're doing. We ask that there's no applause at the end of this, that you stay silent, that you just sit in the space as the shadows increase, and things get darker, like to just allow ourselves to be a part of this story today. So we'll maintain silence and we'll just kind of sit here and just take it all in. So please, no applause. And now I would like to turn this over to Reverend Heidi Denman McDougall. She is the pastor of the Strongsville United Church of Christ. I didn't even introduce myself, did I? I'm Reverend Mark Bruner. I'm the pastor at Columbia United Methodist Church. I'm so used to not doing that, and I should be better about it. But I know Reverend Heidi is going to open us with prayer tonight, so I'm going to turn this over to her.
Thank you. Let's pray together. Holy One, in this space we know Sunday is coming, but it's not here yet. So tonight, as we contemplate the final steps of Christ's journey to the cross, we simply invite your Spirit to fill this place and fill our hearts and allow us to be on the streets of Jerusalem, to be in the shadows, to be watching the scene unfold before our eyes, and to truly prepare our hearts. Sunday is coming, but it's not here yet. In your name we pray. Amen.
shadows, the place where light and darkness meet, where light is obstructed. The prophet Isaiah wrote that people living in darkness have seen a great light. On those living in the shadow of death, the light has dawned. Yet, against the light of the manger, a shadow of a cross was already forming. The light was shining, but the darkness did not understand it, and the shadows began to gather. Jesus stood above Jerusalem. He saw the shadow of turning descending on the city, and wept. As he entered her gates, the cheers of the people mingled with the jeers of his accusers. The man of sorrow looked deeper into darkness and heard the hosannas, quickly turning to cries of crucify.
Thank you.
Evening came, and the disciples gathered around their master for the Passover feast. And while they were eating, Jesus made a startling revelation.
I tell you the truth, one of you will betray me, one who is eating with me.
Each of them began to look at the other, and then within their own hearts, the shadow of betrayal swept through the room. Were they capable of such a thing? Sad and one by one, they questioned him, "Lord, is it I?" As Jesus broke the bread and poured the wine, the shadow of sacrifice weighed heavily upon his heart, and he told them,
"This is my body, broken for you, and this is my blood, spilled for your sins. Eat, drink, and remember."
Jesus broke. broken. Take the cup and
darkness took its final hold on Judas as he left the upper room. That night in Gethsemane, Jesus, burdened with sorrow, prayed alone. The shadows continued to lengthen, and in that place of solitude and solace, a place Jesus loved, Judas returned. He brought with him those to whom he had sold not only his teacher, but himself. He betrayed the Lord with a kiss, and the soldiers led Jesus away. Fleeing in fear, the disciples abandoned him, and he was left in the shadow of loneliness. Darkness reigned. It was night.
Oh,
The soldiers bound Jesus and handed him over to Pilate. He was led like a lamb to the slaughter. He stood in the shadow of suffering and said not a word.
Lamb without spot or blemish.
darkness came face to face. Behold, the Lamb of God, who takes away the sin of the world. Have mercy on us and grant us peace. Creation groaned and wept as her creator died.